G'day and welcome back to Build Some. And in this video I want to show you a bit about the process of cutting and filling to getting blocks of land level, and then some subsequent things that we need to do with our footing system to make sure they don't crack and break due to the different types of soil. So what I've got here is your typical house block. This one has a fairly good slope on it. It's actually about a 4 meter slope across the length of this block. So we've got a couple of options. We could work with the slope, and I'll look at that in some future videos, or we can level the block. So today I'm going to look at leveling it, and we use what we call cut and fill. So you'd find a level that's roughly half the height of the block, and you would then cut out that, so cut down or remove the soil down to that level. And also I've taken all the topsoil off the block as well, because we don't want to be bringing fill in onto vegetation. So I've cut away this part of the block, left a bit of land so I can put my fence on, and I'll have to put a retaining wall in front of that to make sure that doesn't want to collapse. So my block of land's now cut, but I've still got this uneven section here, and that's going to be filled. So we bring in fill, and I've made that a different shade just so we can differentiate between the natural soil, naturally compacted soil, and the artificially compacted soil, because it doesn't matter how well we pack this in, it's going to have a different compaction to our natural soil. Okay, so there's our cut in this half and our fill in this half, all retained with the appropriately designed retaining walls, and I'll look at retaining walls again in a future video. So then our footing system's going to get dropped in, and you can see we've got the same footing system running through the two different types of soil. And as I said, because they're a different compaction, then the chances are they're going to move differently, and that can cause uneven movement in the house, and therefore cracking cracking in the actual building. So we have to make sure that the half that's in the fill is going to move the same as the half that's in the naturally compacted area of the house. So we put our footing in. And if I pull the fill out for a minute, you can see that this half, this end of the footing, doesn't even sit. It's not even deep enough to make it into the naturally compacted soil. So we have to come up with a way of connecting this half of the footing with our naturally compacted soil, and that's a process called piering. So we drill piers into the bottom of our footing, and that into the naturally compacted soil, and that will assist us in making this half, which is in our fill, move the same as the half that's in our naturally compacted soil. And effectively when we do this, the fill doesn't support our footing. These act like beams or lintels between our piers. So in some cases we actually have to beef up the size of our footing, because we need to allow them to span between our piers. So, you know, they're all designed by a structural engineer, and he'll give you the specs of how many you need, how often, what size, all that sort of good gear, and that will get you a footing system that's going to limit the amount of movement between the two different soil types. And that also applies for slab on ground. The same thing in your thickened edge, you can put piers down and they'll have the same effect. So there we go, there's a quick video on the cut and fill process and looking at a piered footing system to help stop differential movement in the footings.